So in the last session under Python token, we covered till little part, right? So now today's session, we'll be learning about our last Python token operators. So what are these operators? Well, these are some specific character which have a specific task to perform. And based on the function and the task, the operators are further segregated into 7 different types of operators. Arithmetic operator, assignment operator, comparison operator, logical operator, bitwise, identity, and membership operator. Fine. So let me discuss them one by one. So starting with arithmetic operator. Well, arithmetic operators are the one which is used to perform some arithmetic calculation. So what it does, it takes two operand to perform operation on them. For example, 2 plus 3. So here 2 and 3 are operand. And the character plus over here is nothing but arithmetic operator. Alright? So there are other arithmetic operators too. Like plus, minus, multiplication, division, mod. All these characters are a part of arithmetic operator. Let me just show you one more example. Like 1 plus 2. So you have 1 and 2 are the operand and plus here is a arithmetic operator. 1 minus 2, again minus is a arithmetic operator. 2 mod 1, mod is what? Arithmetic operator. Alright, let's move ahead. Next we have is the assignment operator. Well, this assignment operator is used to assign a value to a variable. The character which comes under this operator are equal to, plus equal to, minus equal to, multiplication equal to, and etc. For example, you declare a variable as var equal 10. So this equal to is your assignment operator and is used to assign value to a variable. Let's get back to our Jupyter notebook and learn more about it. So for example, I'm defining a variable var equal 10. So this equal to is nothing but an assignment operator. Var plus equal 10, again an assignment operator. But what does this mean? So what does this mean? Well, it means that var equal var plus 10. Alright. So if you print the value of var, what do you think the output should be? Well, you'll get the output as 20. Since the value of var is already 10. So 10 plus 10, it's 20. So the updated value of var is 20. Similarly, you can perform var minus equal to 10 and again get your value printed. So again, the updated value of var would be 20 minus 10, 10. So this plus equal to or minus equal to, it is generally named as a shorthand, which means add or subtract and assign value to self. Alright? Same example is mentioned over here, like a equal 10. A multiply equal to 10. So it means that A equal 10 into 10. When you print A, you'll get the output as 100. Alright. So next we have is comparison operator. Well, it is used to compare two values and it returns true or false as the output. Alright. The operators which are a part of it are less than, greater than, less than equal to, greater than equal to, or not equal to. For example, let's see what example we have up here. A equal 10, B equal 20. A is greater than B. Obviously, 10 is not greater than 20, right? So it is giving me false as the output. Alright, fine. So let's move ahead. Next is the logical operator. Well, these logical operators are used to perform some logical calculation. And the operators or the keywords which are a part of it are AND, OR, and NOT. For example, we have A equal 10 is less than 10 and 2 is greater than minus 1. Then print A. So you are getting output as false. Okay. Let's jump back to our Jupyter notebook and see why we are getting the output as false. So you had A equal 10 is less than 10 and 2 is greater than minus 1. So if you see, we have two comparison operator up here. So what is the value of 10 less than 10? Since it is a comparison operator, so it will give me a false, right? 10 is not less than 10. And 2 is greater than minus 1. This is true. So you can summarize this as false and true. Alright. So since it's false and true, therefore it equals to false. Well, how? Well, do you remember the binary calculation that you have learned in your college? It's like 1.1 equal 1, or 1.0 equal 0, or 1 and 1 equal 1, or 1 and 0 is 0. So consider true as 1 and false as 0. So false and true is false. Alright, that's why you got the result as false. Now if you print the value of A, you'll get the output as false. Alright, so next we have is the bitwise operator. So this operator is used to perform the bitwise calculation. This operator includes AND, OR, left shift, right shift, NOT. Alright, so let's see their use one by one. Let's see the example what we have up here. So we have 7 or 5, the output is 7. 7 and 5, the output is 5. So how do you think we are getting this output? Let's see the calculation. So how it is calculated? So if you convert 7 into its binary form, it's 111. And if you convert 5 into its binary form, it's 101. Now if you are performing OR, so basically you are performing a binary addition on it. And if you are performing an AND, you are performing a binary multiplication on it. Alright, so let's see. So if you are performing a binary addition on it, so 1 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0 is again 1. And again 1 plus 1 is 1. So that's why you are getting the OR of 7 and 5 as 7. Even you can verify this using the calculator. Open a calculator. Yeah, it's a programmer calculator. So 7 or 5. So you'll get the output as 7. That's correct. Fine. Next operator that we have got up here is tilde operator or the NOT operator. Well, this operator is used to perform a NOT operation. So what is NOT of 7? What is NOT of 7? It's minus 8, right? How it is minus 8? Let me just show you using a notepad. Let's open notepad. Alright. So 7 in its binary form with 4 bits, what it is? 0, 1, 1, 1. Alright. If you perform a NOT of 7, that is NOT of 7, what you will get? All the bits would be switched. Like 0 would be converted to 1, again 1 to 0, again 1 to 0. So you'll get 1000 and automatically a negative sign would be added at the beginning. So you'll get minus 1000 in binary form, which you convert into decimal, you'll get it as minus of 8. Alright? That's why the output of NOT of 7 is minus 8. Fine? Next is the left shift and right shift operator. Let's see what is the output first. For example, I am trying for a right shift, then 10 right shift 2. What is the output? It's 2. Let's see how we got the output as 2. Open our notepad. Let's remove this. So 10 in its binary form, what it is? It's 1010. Alright. Well, when you are performing the right shift, you are telling the interpreter that you want to shift your bits toward right. And how many bits you want to shift is basically 2, since you have mentioned 10 right shift 2. Alright. So 1010 shifted 2 bits to the right. 00 and remove 10 from the end. Alright. So this is how you are shifting 2 bits towards the right. So you got the result as 0010. But now if you convert this into decimal form, you'll get the output as 2. Fine. So it's like you're trying to push 2 bits from the left towards the right. Is it clear? Alright, fine. Let's move ahead. Next we have is 10 left shift 2. What is the output? It's 40. Let's see how we got that output. Again, 10 in its binary form is 1010. So when you're performing a left shift, it's like pushing the bits from right towards the left. So 10 left shift 2 is like 1010 and you are adding 2 bits in the end, since you are shifting 2 bits to the left. So you are getting 10100. So let's convert this into its decimal form. So 10100 in its decimal form is what? 40. So that is why you are getting the result as 40. So there's a shortcut trick. Well, the shortcut trick is that just add zeros equal to the number of bits that you want to shift towards the left. Alright? For example, I want to perform 10 left shift 3. So my output should be 10100 and one more zero. Alright? Since I'm moving 3 zeros. Alright? Since I'm moving 3 zeros towards the left. So let's convert it. So it's 80. So you are getting the output as 80. Let's verify it again. Well, if you perform 10 left shift 3, you'll get the output as 80. Fine. Well, I hope the bitwise operator is clear to you guys. Well, in case you have slightest doubt, please add your doubt to the comment section below and we'll try to reply them at the earliest. For now, we can just move ahead to the identity operator. Well, these operators are used to test if two operands share an identity. The operators which are a part of it are is and is not. These are basically two keywords. Alright? For example, what we have up here, x equal 10, x is 10. It's true. Or x equal 10, x is not 10, it's false. Alright? It is just used to test if the operand shares an identity or not. Alright? So next and the final operator in Python is the membership operator. Well, this operator is used to test whether a value is a member of a sequence or not. The sequence may be a list, it can be a string, or it can be a tuple. I know some of you guys might be thinking, what is this list or what is this tuple? And guys, I'd say that just be patient. I'll teach you about them in detail during this session. For now, you can just understand that this list is almost same as array which you had already studied in C, C++, or Java. It's almost same as that. Alright? And this membership operator, it is used when you want to check if a certain element is present in a list or not. So let's see what are the operators which are a part of it. So well, we have in and not in keywords which are a part of this membership operator. Alright, let's see an example. So what's the example up here? So we have defined a list, or you can say we have defined an array which consists of dog, cat and wolf. So we are checking for lion and pets. Since pet is the name of a list or an array, you can say, so we are searching for lion and pets. So since there is no lion in it, so the result is false. Next, what we are doing, we are seeing for wolf and pets. So yeah, wolf is present in pet. So we are getting output as true. Alright. So this was all for this session. In our next session, we'll learn about various data types which we use in Python. Thank you.